The Opportunity Challenge is a joint grant-making initiative between the West Miriam Assefa Fund and the Tarsadia Foundation with the goal of empowering immigrant and refugee communities to thrive. Over 400 organizations applied to the Opportunity Challenge. We selected 12 incredible organizations to be grantee partners. Three of those organizations were convened to discuss their work to enable the economic mobility of immigrants and refugees by providing crucial support services outside the workplace, such as affordable childcare, healthcare, and technology. Featuring Many Languages, One Voice, Sueños Sin Fronteras, and Suma. We spoke to leaders from these organizations and asked them about their efforts to ensure access to better supports for immigrants and refugees. Why is the work you're doing so important?
Many Languages, One Voice is an immigrant-led and based organization that's been in DC for 15 years, fighting for the rights of childcare providers, street vendors, immigrant communities in general, and youth. Currently, we do sanctuary organizing, taking children out of detention at the border and resettling them here. We work with childcare workers to help them recover from COVID and the economic crisis around a mutual aid model. And we're also working with street vendors to build an independently run street vendor co-op.
Sueños Sin Fronteras, we are the only organization, collective in South Texas, specifically focused on reproductive justice for undocumented and immigrant women and families. And we do this through community-based pathways that are centered around liberation, autonomy, and self-empowerment.
Suma is a new organization in Northeast Portland's Cully neighborhood. And we're really focusing on broader political awareness, consciousness building work in community around, well, why is my data so valuable that these large institutions are trying to take it from me as cheaply as possible? And what would happen if we as a community started to organize around our data and use it to achieve community priorities?
What has been an unexpected learning from 2020?
We've been able to train and organize more volunteers and here that are able to support families with issues of housing, food, access to healthcare. So that has been a big challenge, but also a great opportunity for us to cement ourselves in what mutual aid can look like for undocumented communities here in San Antonio.
Lack of access to devices, to the internet, to training, is heightened in the pandemic because so much of the response is online. And initially, we were able to access a very small donation of 100 Chromebooks and made these Chromebooks available to frontline organizations for distribution to community members. And upcoming, we'll be making 3,500 Chromebook kits with internet access and training available to frontline organizations to distribute.
How does Suma plan to build a more inclusive technology economy?
We want to start with investment in community and meeting folks where they're at. So accessible presentations and curriculum and educational sessions in community. And we want to use that not just to build skills, digital skills, but also to build digital capacity and awareness of the value of personal information. And so we want to work with community members to build a different kind of platform, a platform that, in a very old school sense, aggregates their purchasing power towards its own priorities.
How do you see the Opportunity Challenge grant helping you drive more impact in your community?
I think that the limit is our imagination, and that the pandemic has taught us to frame our demands and to dream really big so that we're not already cutting ourselves short and using the language of the systems that oppress us in terms of what we think we can actually win.
Definitely continuing building our reproductive justice programming, which includes a network of birth workers and full spectrum doulas that can address the reproductive needs of the immigrant community. And ultimately, to be able to have our leadership be represented by the immigrant community that we serve.
Our greatest impact, we hope, will be in designing this platform, a platform that allows community members to access critical goods and services at a lower price. And so what this incredibly important grant is going to allow us to do is to design and prototype that platform, to test it. And we hope that if we can do it in Portland, then we can do it almost anywhere in the United States.